Hello, internet people. This is Arceus once more on a little bit of an interesting thing for Munday. As you know, there is a tradition on Tumblr where the moon or mundane, I don't know how you pronounce it, but I don't really care, will do something special about themselves on Munday because, you know, funny little pun. Anyway, I decided to copy off of Lupin because she is freaking awesome and you should go hug her and stuff. And answer a couple questions as myself in a video, of course. And the very first thing I got in my inbox was a really nice anon for once that said, "We love you so much, Arceus!" Whoever sent that, seriously, I want to send you, I don't know. I don't have any money, but I will send you something. I don't know. Anyway, my first real question is, of course, from Lupin, your neighborhood werewolf. My least favorite TV show. And, well, I don't mean to sound like a hipster or anything, but I don't watch very much TV because my family doesn't get cable. Oh well. Let's see. I think the only thing that I really didn't like are hospital shows because I have a really paralyzing fear of hospitals. Yeah. It's just what happens when someone has seen so much death and other such nasty things in their life. So then another anonymous person said, "Could you make a list of your favorite food, color, video game, and book?" And I can. My favorite food would be steak, just like Ness. Woohoo! Earthbound is so much fun. And my favorite color is, of course, blue. More specifically, dark blue, like a navy or something like that. You know, the color on my thoughts blog is one of my favorite colors because I really, really like that dark blue. Which is also why I'm wearing a Sonic hat right now. I have to do everything in a silly hat, just like the doctor. My favorite video game would be Mother 3 because, well, what can I say? It's beautiful. And I can relate with it really darn well. I lost my father when I was really little, and Lucas lost his mother while he was really little. While I don't have a brother or any siblings to speak of, it's just really nice and comforting to me. As for my favorite book, well, I have to go with the Percy Jackson series for that. I know, it's kind of a cop-out, but what can I say? They're all so darn good. That guy, Rick Riordan, or however you pronounce your name, because I'm a horrible pronouncer of names and such things like that, you are a genius, because of humor. And another anonymous person asked, "Who is my favorite role player on here, and why?" You just had to ask that, didn't you? Well, I really don't have a favorite role player, because you guys are all seriously so awesome. I guess I have to say, change this to preferred? Nah, that still sounds bad. Whatever. All I can say is that I really, really like Doc Letheus, and you should totally go follow him and stuff, because he writes like a beast. And I also really like Kath and Karma, because they're so nice to me and stuff. And I really feel comfortable around them. I also like Liz because, well, again, she goes through some trouble like me. Mental, physical, all that crap. And now we have a whole bunch of stuff from DarkX64. Which is another one of my favorite people on here, but I haven't gotten the chance to roleplay with him a lot. Oh well. What fictional character would I make out with and why? For that, I have this. Yes. Zero. Why should be goddamn obvious? Just look at that hair! Look at that! That is why I have long hair. And this. Not sure if you can see that too well, but this is a Renaissance Festival leather thing that is black and awesome and makes me look like Zero. Yeah! Alright, and then he goes on to ask, what are my life goals and plans? Do I look like a man who has a plan? Sorry, I just had to. Well, I'm really hoping to become a veterinarian in the future, or something like that, because I really love animals. As if it wouldn't be obvious enough from playing a cat. And I really want to help them get better and stuff. And plus, I'm going to have a boatload of cats when I get rich and stuff. And of course, I'll have a pet fox because those guys are freaking adorable. So I will need a lot of veterinary skill to take care of them, and of course, to provide the money for them. I will probably make my house more of a pet house than a person house. Alright. And then he asks, let's get personal. What are some traits of your ideal? Well, I guess I'm sort of having trouble understanding. Sorry, I'm just crazy and autistic and, of course, stuff like that. But I'm guessing ideal person or something like that. Well, I'd really have to say someone like my father, because he was in the solar industry, even after Reagan cut all the funding and stuff. And he was a very kind man who would always make work through things and fight for what he believes in. And, you know, he was really stand-up and phenomenal. He had a nice deep voice and he was tall. He had a fuzzy beard that I liked scratching my back on when I was little. And he would always hug and cuddle whenever you wanted it. And of course, when I was little, I had some fun with him and his tail. But despite all the pain that I brought, he still loved me to pieces and let me wear his hat. Which is probably why I want to wear crazy hats all the time. I don't know. But yeah, I guess my ideal would be just be like my father. You know, really kind and understanding to everyone, regardless of what happens. He's the kind of person that if he was a convenience store owner or someone, and someone came up with a gun or something, he would just give him the money right away, and then some, you know, and then some snacks or something to make them feel better about their life, and some advice or something like that, because he's just a really nice human being in general. Alright then, so looking at the time, this is running about 9 minutes, so I will stop here just for the sake of uploading. So part 2 is coming up right after this.